गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो टुडे विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग आवर डिस्कशन ऑन लिमिट्स एंड सीक्वेंसेस ऑफ सेट्स। ओके, सो वी हैव सीन अ कपल ऑफ एग्जांपल्स ऑफ कन्वर्जेंट सीक्वेंसेस, बट वी हैव नॉट इन द रियल सेंस वी हैव नॉट सीन द एग्जांपल ऑफ नॉन कन्वर्जेंट सीक्वेंस। वी डिड सी कपल ऑफ एग्जांपल्स वेयर द लिमिट वॉज गोइंग फाइ और समथिंग। सो लेट अस ट्राई विथ सम नॉन कन्वर्जेंट सीक्वेंसेस नाउ। Let an, n greater than or equal to 1, be a sequence of sets defined in the following manner. So how do I define? So I define an as, say, 1, 2, 3, if n is odd, and we define an as, say, 2, 3, 4, if n is even. Okay? An is defined as 1, 2, 3 if n is odd, and an is defined as 2, 3, 4 if n is even. And now in this case, let us try to find limsu and liminf. Okay? So first we will start with limsu. So let limsup n be, okay, we don't need to give any name to the limsup n, so we can just say limsup n is equal to intersection, by definition union, ak, k greater than or equal to n, n greater than or equal to 1. This is my definition of limsup n. And we have been calling this quantity as Bn, right? So let us first compute Bn. So Bn is, union. So Bn is union AK, K greater than or equal to 1. So in this case, Bn would be C. It depends on two things, whether my n is odd or n is even. So if suppose my n is odd, then I have to start with an odd set. So that is 1, 2, 3 union 2, 3, 4 union 1, 2, 3 union 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay, this will continue. So if bn is n is odd, then we start with this. So this becomes, let me move on. Okay, yeah, so this becomes equal to, anyway, 1 2 3 4, but we are saying everything is for when n is odd. Okay, even if n is even, then what happens? Definition remains the same, bn is union ak, but I have to start with 2 3 4, because now I have to start with even n. So 2 3 4 union 1 2 3 union 2 3 4 union 1 2 3 and so on. So this becomes again 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this is for even n. So what I am getting is Bn is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 for every n greater than or equal to 1. And therefore, my limsup of ans is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, limsup is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let us go to liminf. So what is liminf here? Now liminf of an, by definition, is union intersection ak, k greater than or equal to n, n greater than or equal to 1, and we have called this portion as cn. Okay, So let me first compute Cn. Cn is intersection AK, K greater than or equal to n. So this is equal to, now let me again focus on say odd n. So if I focus on odd n, my Cn becomes 1, 2, 3, intersection with 2, 3, 4, intersection with 1, 2, 3, intersection with 2, 3, 4, and so on. Okay. So this becomes 2, 3 for odd n. Okay. Similarly, if I try to define for even n, it's going to start with 2, 3, 4. So it would be 2, 3, 4, intersection with 1, 2, 3, intersection with 2, 3, 4, intersection with 1, 2, 3, and so on. So this becomes again a 2, 3, but this is for even n. So basically, irrespective of whether my n is odd or even, I am getting 2, 3. As a result, my lim inf a n is going to be union c n, which is equal to 2, 3. Okay. So what we are getting? We are getting lim inf a n as 2, 3, and it is subset of lim sup a n, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. In fact, here it is actually a proper subset. So this part is not there. So I can say that lim inf a n is not equal to lim sup a n, and therefore limit a n does not exist. Okay, now here let me try to focus on what we discussed while proving that lim inf is subset of lim sup. We defined something called as, you know, being infinitely often and being present in finitely many ends. So this is exactly what is happening here. So see, what was my definition of an? So my an is 1, 2, 3 if n is odd, and my an is 2, 3, 4 if n is even. And we have found out that my lim inf an is 2, 3, whereas my lim sup an is 1, 2, 3, 4. So what are the implications of these things? See, 1, 2, 3 when n is odd, so we know that number of odd natural numbers is infinite. So basically n is equal to 1, 2, 3 infinitely often. Similarly, n is equal to 2, 3, 4 also infinitely often. What it means in terms of individual elements? In terms of individual elements, 1 belongs to an for every odd n, right? Similarly, 4 belongs to an for every even n, and 2, 3 belong to an for every n. Okay? So, 1 belongs to an for every odd n means 1 belongs to an infinitely often, because number of odd numbers is infinite. Okay. Similarly, 4 belongs to an infinitely often. And what about 2, 3? 2, 3 of course belong to an infinitely often, but in fact, there is something further. There is no n in which 2, 3 don't belong. So 2, 3 belong to an, I can say, for all but finitely many n. In fact, here that finitely many is 0. Okay. All but finitely many n. Okay. So, and that is exactly what has happened. That's why 1, 2, 3, 4, which are occurring infinitely often, they are in limb soup, whereas only 2-3 are occurring in all but finitely many n, so they are in limb inf, and hence here limb inf is proper subset of limb soup, and since limb inf is proper subset of limb soup, they are not equal, so the limit does not exist. Okay, so this is important. So even though 1 and 4 are occurring in infinitely many n's, they are not in limb inf because they don't occur in all but finitely many n's. Okay, if you are finding this all but finitely many business difficult to understand, let me try to explain it a bit further. See, what do I mean by all but finitely many? So let me define a new sequence. So A1 is say 1, A2 is suppose 1, 2, A3 is suppose defined as 1, 2, 3, A4 is defined as now 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I am changing. So see, A4 is not in the same pattern. So A5 is defined as 3, 4, 5. Now A6 is defined as 4, 5, 6, dot dot dot. And A7 is now suppose defined as 1, 2, 3, 4 all. A8 is defined as 8, 9, 10 and all. And now A9 onwards I am defining it as same as A8. Okay, so basically I am saying A10 is equal to A11, everything is same as 8, 9, 10. Okay, now what are the things here which are occurring finitely often, infinitely often, and so on. Okay, so here see, when I say A8, A9, A10, everything is 8, 9, 10. So basically what I am claiming is AN is same as 8, 9, 10, dot, dot, dot for every N greater than or equal to 8. Okay. So except for finitely many N's, means up from 1, 2, 3 up to say 7. If I leave out these finitely many N's, then An is equal to this for every n after that. Okay, so what I can say is, An is equal to 8, 9, 10 and so on for all but finitely many n's. Okay, here I, of course, that means that An is equal to this set infinitely many times also, because the number of times An is equal to this set is actually infinite. So this is true, infinitely many N. Okay, no doubt about that. So this is true, no doubt about that, but this is, you know, a more stronger statement. Okay. Whereas in the earlier case, when I said, I'm now talking about earlier example, when I said an is 1, 2, 3 for every odd n, I cannot say this. Okay. Because I can say this, that an is equal to 1, 2, 3 infinitely, for infinitely many n's, because for every odd number it is happening. But I cannot say it is for all but finitely many n, because I cannot find a finite n beyond which n is always equal to 1, 2, 3. That does not happen. Okay. So this is the difference between all but finitely many and just infinitely many. Is it okay? Hope the difference is clear. Okay, so we have seen an example of a non-convergent sequence where lim sup and lim inf are non-trivial. When I say non-trivial, I mean non-empty, and still they are unequal, and hence the limit does not exist. Okay, now we have to study a couple of properties of lim sup lim inf, but for that we need to first revise some set results. Okay, so if I have two sets, two sequences of sets, let's say I have an n greater than or equal to 1 as one sequence of sets, and bn n greater than or equal to 1 as another sequence of sets, what can I say about an union bn? Then I am further taking union over all n's. Okay, so can I say that this is equal to union an n greater than or equal to 1 union over union bn n greater than or equal to 1? Okay, this is the question. Can we say this? In fact, there are three more such questions that we can pose. So let me try to list all of them. So this is the first one. Second one would be union n greater than or equal to 1 an intersection bn. Can we say this is equal to union an intersection union bn? Third question is intersection n greater than or equal to 1 an union bn, is it equal to intersection an n greater than or equal to 1 union intersection bn n greater than or equal to 1? Okay, and fourth question is union both the things we have already done. So intersection n greater than or equal to 1 an intersection bn, is it same as intersection an n greater than or equal to 1 intersected with intersection bn n greater than or equal to 1? Okay, these are the four things we want to examine, whether they are true or false. If our claim is they are true, we need to give a proof. If our claim is they are false, we need to give a counter example. Okay, so basically what is this? So we are trying to say here that union is distributive over union. I mean, whether we are trying to examine whether union is distributive over union. Here we are trying to examine whether union is distributive over intersection. But of course, the inside thing is finite and this is infinite. Okay, so we are trying to say whether a countable union, so here if I drop, whether a countable union, is it distributive over a finite intersection? Similarly, whether a countable intersection, is it distributive over a finite union, and so on. Okay, so let me start with the first part. And do you have any hunch? Do you feel whether it's going to be equal or unequal? Okay, let us try to write down what we have on both the sides and see if we can connect them. So how do you prove equality of two sets? If you want to prove equality of two sets, then we can prove that the first set is subset of second and the second set is subset of first. So if we can prove inclusion in both ways, then we have established equality. So let us try for the first part. Okay, so part one here, my LHS is union over union. So LHS is let me give some name to that LHS. So let me say K. So K is union N greater than or equal to 1, AN union BN, and suppose L is the RHS, that is L is union AN N greater than or equal to 1, union with union BN N greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so I want to examine, so we don't know whether it is true or false, we want to examine whether K is subset of L and L is subset of K, because if we prove both ways then we would have established the equality. Okay, so let us try to prove K is subset of L and see if we face any hurdles. So let omega belongs to K, let omega belong to K, what does it imply? It implies omega belongs to union N greater than or equal to 1, AN union BN. So omega is in this big countable union, means omega is in this inside thing for at least one N. So this implies omega belongs to AN union BN for at least one N. Okay, so this implies omega belongs to AN or omega belongs to BN for at least one N. Okay, so if omega belongs to AN, can I say omega belongs to union AN? And if omega belongs to intersection, if omega belongs to BN, I can say omega belongs to union BN. Okay, and hence I can say that omega belongs to either union AN or union BN, it is in at least one of them, so omega belongs to L. So therefore what we have established is K is subset of L. Okay, now let us try to check if the reverse is true. So if I start with omega in L, it implies omega belongs to union AN union union BN. Okay, which means omega belongs to either union AN or omega belongs to union BN. So if omega belongs to union AN, I can say omega belongs to AN for some N, or omega belongs to BN for some N. So it means that omega is in AN union BN for some N. Okay, as a result omega belongs to union of AN union BN. Okay, which was nothing but my K. Therefore we have proved L is also subset of K. Okay, hence using both these results we have established that union over N greater than or equal to 1 AN union BN is same as union over AN union union over BN. Okay, N greater than or equal to 1, N greater than or equal to 1. Thus what we have proved is this countable union is distributive over finite union. Okay, in the second we want to check similar thing for intersection. So we want to check whether countable union, whether it is distributive over finite intersection. Okay, so let us try to check this. So how do I proceed? Initially let us try to proceed in the similar manner and see if we get stuck at some step. So now let me call this as my K and this as my L. So my K and L have changed. So let omega belong to union n greater than or equal to 1 an intersection bn. What does it mean? It means that omega belongs to at least one of this. Okay, so this implies omega belongs to an intersection bn for at least one n. Let that n be say n naught. Okay, so this means omega belongs to an naught and omega belongs to bn naught. I'm saying and now because omega is in intersection. Okay, so omega belongs to an naught and omega belongs to bn naught. This would mean omega belongs to finally, where do I want to reach? I want to reach at union n intersection union bn. Okay, fine. So what I can say is omega belongs to union n and omega belongs to union bn, because it is in an naught, so it is in union n. It is in bn naught, so it is in intersection union bn. Therefore omega belongs to union an intersected with union bn. Okay, n greater than or equal to 1, n greater than or equal to 1. Therefore omega belongs to L. Okay, because this is my RHS. So we have established K is subset of L. No problem till that point. What about the reverse way? So now I have to start with L and check whether it is subset of K. Okay, so start with omega belonging to L, which means omega belonging to union an intersected with union bn. Okay, so omega is in union an intersected with omega bn. So this means omega is in union an and omega is in union bn. Okay, so this implies that omega is in an for at least one n and omega is in bn for at least one n. Okay, now from this, can I say omega belongs to an intersection bn? That is the question. See, it is like saying that suppose you and your friend decide that you want to meet in the coming week. Okay, so today is Monday, so you decide that in this week, between Monday to Sunday, we should meet. Okay, now for that, and you decide a third common place, so you are not meeting at your own place as well as not your friend's place, so you are meeting at, let's say, in the department. You are meeting in the department. So department is the common place where you both have to go. So if both of you want to meet at least once this week, both of you have to go to the department at least once. Am I right? Now suppose you don't communicate. You just decide that yes, both of us have to be in the department at least once for us to meet. So you go to the department on Tuesday. So because you feel that okay, I have to go at least once and then I can meet him. The friend goes to the department on Friday, so technically both of you have been there at least once. But would you meet? No, because the at least once day for you is different from the day at least once day for your friend. As a result, even though both of you, technically both of you being in the department at least once should have been enough, provided you both chose the same day. However, since you didn't choose the same day, you are not going to meet even if you are there at least once. Okay, so same thing can happen here. When I say omega belongs to an, for at least one n, it may mean that omega belongs to some an naught and omega belongs to some bm naught, where n naught is not equal to m naught. I'm not saying this has to happen, but this is a possibility. Okay, so even with this statement, this is true. In fact, both these are true. So in such a case, omega can never belong to an intersection bn. Okay, so if suppose this happens, then omega cannot belong to an intersection bn for any n. Okay, and then in that case omega cannot belong to union of an intersection bn. Okay, so this side of the proof has some problem here. So we should now see that probably this result is not true. So if I want to claim that this result is not true, what should I do? Ideally, I should give a counter example. Okay, so can you think of some counter example? So what I want is, I want an counter example which says that this equality, so I want an example which says that this equality, does not hold. Okay, so I want some sets A and Bn where union A and intersection Bn is not equal to this, and we got the point how to do that we can see from here. So we want some omega which is in An for some n but which is in Bm for some different n. Okay, so think. So, how can I proceed? So, maybe we can use the same example that we used earlier for proving non-convergence. Let us try. We are not sure. Let us try. So, if I define an as say 1, 2, 3 for every odd n and 2, 3, 4 for every even n, and now let me define bn slightly differently. So bn, let me define the reverse way. So bn is 2, 3, 4 for every odd n and bn is 1, 2, 3 for every even n. Okay, bn is 1, 2, 3 for every even n. So, what is an intersection bn? Okay, so now we will compute both the quantities k and l. So, here in this particular example, my k is union n greater than or equal to 1 over an intersection bn. So an intersection bn, what is it? So union n greater than or equal to 1, we need to compute an intersection bn. So okay, so you can see here that an intersection bn for odd n, it would be 1, 2, 3 intersection 2, 3, 4. So it would be 2, 3 for odd n, and for even n it would be 2, 3, 4 intersection 1, 2, 3. So for even n also it would be 2, 3. Okay, so an intersection bn is 2, 3 for odd n as well as even n. So this is union over the same set, so k is basically just 2, 3. Okay, and now what is L? So L is union AN intersected with union BN, right? So union over ANs is 1, 2, 3, 4, union over all n's is 1 2 3 4 and union over all bn's is also 1 2 3 4 so my l is actually 1 2 3 4 okay so you can see here k is subset of l in fact we proved that k is subset of l but l is not subset of k so if I define if this is my l I can easily see that l is not subset of k okay because again the same problem union an is 1 2 3 4 union bn is 1 2 3 4 but this 1 and 4 they are never in an intersection bn because 1 is in odd ans and 1 is in even bns I mean bns with even n okay as a result reverse story for 4 as a result 1 and 4 are never in an intersection bn and hence they cannot come here okay so this is an important result that this countable union is not distributive over finite intersection okay countable union is not distributive over finite intersection we have just gone through the first two parts of what we are trying to establish there are two more parts okay so let me go back to them yes so now I have to worry about intersection over union and intersection over intersection so can we use these first two results to say something about the third and fourth result so I think we can go for De Morgan's law okay so let us try that so what I know is the first part is true so let me use De Morgan's law so my first part says union n greater than or equal to 1 an union bn this is same as union an union union bn okay this is my first part so by De Morgan's law if I take complement here and complement here still it should hold because if a is equal to b a complement is equal to b complement so what are the complements so union has to become intersect so let me write this would be intersection of an union bn complement by De Morgan's law right union something whole complement is intersection over the complement of inside thing and this would become union an whole complement intersection with union bn whole complement same logic so this is intersection n greater than equal to 1 and an union bn complement is nothing but an complement intersection with bn complement okay so this is same as from here intersection an complement intersection with intersection bn complement okay so De Morgan's law can probably help but this is actually thinking backwards I don't want to prove the result for complements I ideally want to prove the results for original things okay but from here now you can see that an complements are going to be some sets okay so let us try to go give a formal proof so this is just thinking aloud so let us so this gives me an idea that intersection over intersection is probably okay means intersection is probably distributive over intersection so that is what my I think result number 4 was am I right yeah result number 4 so result number 4 is probably true so let us start with result number 4 and see if I can establish that so result 4 is intersection n greater than or equal to 1 an intersection bn is equal to intersection an intersection bn okay
So what we did earlier was, as I said, it is thinking backward. See, you when you were a child, you might have solved some puzzles where, you know, you had to find a way out. So they used to have, let me draw a picture. So they used to have something like, you know, maybe a house here and a dog here. I don't know how to draw a dog. Assume this is a dog. Okay, a house here and a dog here, and you want this dog to reach the house. So there would be something like this. Okay, so this is one way. And then they would complicate this by, you know, drawing some maze or something like this. And only one of the ways actually reaches the house. So they expected you to find a correct way. So ideally, if you start from here, generally somewhere in between the road gets blocked. So you start with other way and so on. So the smarter ones, what they used to do, they would start from here. Because many a times, only one way would reach here. So they would start from here, go backwards, and reach the desired way. Okay. So this is exactly what we have to do in many proofs. So start thinking backwards. This is exactly what we did here by De Morgan's law. Okay. But as I said, in writing the proof, we can't write backwards. So we have to start forward. So I want to establish that this is true. So let me start by saying that, okay, I would use the result one on the complements. So we know that the result one is true. So let us assume that result one for complements. So using the result one that we proved earlier, result one, we can say that union n greater than or equal to 1, an complement union bn complement. So we are applying that result to an complements and bn complements. We can apply that result to any set. So in particular, we are choosing complements of the sets in which we are interested. So is same as union n complement union bn complement. And now we would say apply De Morgan's law here. Okay, so take complement on both the sides. So I have union n greater than or equal to 1, an complement union bn complement whole complement is same as union n complement whole complement union, oh sorry, not this, I have to take whole complement. So union bn complement, and this is whole complement. Okay, so what does this mean? This means that intersection over an complement union bn complement whole complement is same as union an complement complement intersection over union bn complement complement. So this part is intersection of complement of these would be an union okay, there is some problem. This is intersection. Okay. So now this union has to become intersection. Because I am applying complement, this union also has to change. Okay, by De Morgan's law, union has to become intersection. So, intersection BN. Okay, so see, let me explain this because this is slightly confusing. So what I have is, let us focus only on this part, forget about the outside intersection. So I have some set here, union with some other set here, and then whole complement. So what it means by De Morgan's law, you take complement of this set, complement of this set, and change the sign of this. Okay, that's exactly what we are doing. So this would be same as here, same story. So intersection of AN's, this intersection won't change, intersection of BN's, because now we are applying De Morgan's law to individual brackets, so this thing won't change. And this is what we want, intersection AN
intersection BN is same as intersection of AN whole intersected with intersection BN. Okay, now some homework. So what is the homework? Out of 1, 2, 3, 4, I have solved three things. I won't say prove, because second we have disproved. Now your job is to do something about three. So examine whether it is true or not. If it is true, give the proof. If it is not true, give a counter example. Okay, so this part three is your homework. We are going to use these results for saying something about unions and intersections of sets and limsups of unions and intersections. But today, let me stop here. Okay, thank you.